Hello and welcome to Frontier Community Access Television. Tom Albert and Miss Chapley, as well as Alec Eckel. We have the Frontier Redhawks versus the Smith Academy Eagles. And it's going to be a good game today. Frontier, they're 4-1-2. So they got two ties on the season. And they have one win in the league and one tie. And Smith Academy, they're 0-1 in their league. And they're coached by Judy Strong. And Frontier's coached by Missy Maha. So we'll be back.
All right, we're lining up.
Just do like...
Yeah, looks like Smith won the coin toss or the decision to start.
So, nice steal there. Now, Rebecca Wallace is going up the sideline. And makes a pass. Shot goes wide left.
So that was interference by our player actually cutting in front. So we lose the ball, and they're going to start at the top of the circle where the infraction took place. So there's a, 20-foot circle. I forget the exact distance.
And...
not quite sure what happened on that call.
Oh. Snow audio. There we go.
All right, to start, when you hear the whistle, they have to be 5 yards from the start of the ball.
Go, go, go.
So.
Rebecca Wallace is going down she went all the way down the sideline.
Yeah, she was using the line as a defensive measure. So we went out of bounds. They're going to start at the 25-yard line.
Well, Roach has it. And she makes a pass.
Shot.
Now Smith going down the sideline.
I held Wessel. There's a little contact happening there.
With it. She's trying to get by the defender. Stolen by Smith. Frontier's going down the sideline.
So we have interference with the stick. So Frontier's going to start with the ball. Did you just say that? All right, so we have a corner now. So all but four players from Smith have to come back to the 50-yard line. Four are going to start in the goal with the goalie. He has to come outside the circle and then back into the circle. to score.
Hiliadowski with it.
All right. So now there was a foot on the ball. So they either have to do a back pass or you have to carry it 5 yards. So there was a three-way interference with view.
So Catherine Kokoski is the ball for Smith. Another Roach with it. Pass it over to Harper Modesto.
Nice.
Now Rebecca Wallace-West with it. Trying to get in the box.
Seeing some nice stick handling using the reverse stick as well as their strong-sided front stick. You can only use one side of the stick.
Ah.
Unlike in ice hockey, where you'll see them go back and forth, with field hockey, you're only allowed to use. I have to think about this. when I'm facing, it's facing my left side, and then reverse stick, you have to actually swing it around. I've seen left hand, so it's a disadvantage for people that have left hands or left-handed, and in the past, I've actually seen left-handers use the stick upside down. So the hook itself goes from the top and hooks down to the ground versus from the ground and up into the air. So that was kind of an interesting take on skill.
Yeah, I didn't know you could use only one side of the stick.
Yeah. Yep. If you use the back side, it's an infraction, and they'll call you for it. Can't touch your feet. And a majority of the time, a lot of the calls are the ball touched the offender's foot, or a hack with the stick. And if you're watching number 9, Harper, she does a really good job at keeping her stick on the ground and following the ball, waiting for that opportunity to steal it. But if you come down and hack it, automatic. Out of bounds. Ooh.
So, Rebecca in the box. Ooh.
Ooh. Corner. Touched a foot. It was like right there.
Yeah.
Oh, right there. So, once again, all of the Smith kids are coming up to the 50-yard line, with the exception of the goalie and 4 other players. Ball comes out. It's got to go back in. Shot on goal.
Nice shot.
Very nice. Oh, another corner. More feet. It's all about keeping the stick down on the ground and trying to keep that ball from hitting your feet, especially when you're in the position right in front of the net and you're just trying to clear it out as a defensive player.
So Ashley Taylor's going to take the corner. And Lila Roach makes a pass.
Corner. That just hit her stick the wrong way, rolled right up, hit her.
Got to do a lot of running. This is like 3 corners in a row.
Yes. Now my understanding is Smith is a very young team.
Yeah.
They graduated out almost their whole starting lineup last year. shot on goal. Right. They're calling that against Frontier.
Frontier makes a steal. Ashley Taylor makes a pass shot.
Ooh.
Wide left.
Beautiful setup, though. It just went just wide, but that was picture perfect as far as sending it across the front of the goal for the shot. I think it went out of bounds.
Yeah.
Kind of hard to tell from this angle.
Yeah. Pass.
Nice shot. Whoop. Saved by the goalie. Corner. Hack. It's always interesting listening to people and they talk about how it's a game of whistles and what do all the whistles mean. So Maddie tried to take the shot but missed the ball and hit the other Smith stick, so that's against us.
There's Smith trying to go up the sideline and stolen by Haley Hadowski. Tries to get a pass.
Ooh! Ooh! Come on, ball, stay with it. Oh, nice save.
Yeah. Goalie just kicked it out. Another save.
Corner.
Ooh,
shot on goal. Save. Once again, we had that crossover where there was a blinding because two Frontier players crossed in front of the ball.
Ooh.
Ooh. There goes Lila. She did it nice. She just kind of scooped it right it up on the fly, took it in.
Another nice save by Smith's goalie.
Smith goalie's getting a workout today.
Yeah. Hasn't really been in Frontier's defensive, their side of the field.
Not at all. Definitely Frontier is dominating offensively. We just got to be able to find the hole in the goal. Get it around that goalie. Ooh, that was a nice fake out. Went wide. So Smith College, Smith Academy has the ball.
I have to play this back.
It's been a very long day.
So Charlotte Kavanaugh Ball for Smith. And Haliadowski seals it.
Ooh, nice stop.
Now Claire Kirkendall with it. Tries to get an upfield. And
oh, took a bad bounce there. That's the one issue when you're playing on the grass field. We can get pretty bouncy.
Now Smith on the attack. And nice dish out.
Nice clear to the outside. Kind of dancing around the ball.
So Catherine.
Ooh. Heard that back all the way over here.
Oh, it's gotta hurt. Macy DeMio trying to get it out to the other side.
There we go.
Now Ashley Taylor with
got a 2-on-1. Ooh. Oh, gotta lift it, and lifts. Oh. No goal. That's the end of the first quarter.
So it's
I'm not sure what happened. We had a 2-on-1 going right there, and goalie went down and tried to get in it, and then shot it over, but I'm not quite sure what happened that it wasn't counted.
Yeah.
Didn't quite have the angle to be able to see that.
So after the first quarter, it's 0-0, and we'll be right back with the second quarter action. Watching Frontier Community Access Television. Hello and welcome back to Frontier Community Access Television. Tom Albert, Miss Chapley, and Al Keckel. And
ooh,
Frontier with a big chance.
Big chance. Save. Oh, calling a push or a shove. So back to the top of the circle for Smith. Let's see if Smith can move it out. Definitely Frontier's been dominating offensively. Just can't find the back of the net.
Yeah, and Frontier, they have a bench, whereas Smith doesn't really. They have nobody.
They have nobody. Exactly. And at Frontier, we've been lucky. The rec department has started a youth program, which has been feeding very talented, strong players coming up. Where before they would, most of our field hockey players wouldn't touch a stick till they were in seventh grade.
Yep. It's better to start younger than anything.
Yep.
Now Smith on the attack. And Ashley Taylor moving down the sideline.
Nice spread out front line there, offensive line by front here. Lots and lots of opportunities offensively. Just haven't been able to connect it.
Yeah.
Nice steal.
Yeah. Good steal by, I think it was Claire Kirkendall.
Yep. Frontier, for the most part, is a very young team. I think they only have 3 seniors. Several starters graduated last year. So it's a very young team.
Lila Roach makes a pass to Harper, and now Ashley Taylor. Going to kick it out of there.
Keeping a stick on it. Ooh! It's in!
There you go.
Question is, whose stick did it come off of?
Yeah, I don't know.
We're going to have to do a replay on that one and see who got it in. There was a lot of sticks in there, a lot of players in there. Go purple.
I have no idea. Madison McKimmy. She has it trying to go the middle. She passed it off to Harper Modesto. She's going to pass it up to Ashley Taylor. Going to go up the sideline. It's intercepted.
Nice stop, though. Nice solid stop. Kicking right out. As a defensive player, that's what you really want to do, is you want to get it out to the sidelines.
Charlotte Kavanaugh with it again. Now it's
nice stop. Nice steal right off of there.
Now. So Harper Modesto.
Yep. Harper has to carry it 5 yards before she can pass it into the circle, which she did beautifully. And another goal.
That was Stella Heflin for Frontier.
Who so?
Stella Heflin.
All right. Frontier 2, Smith Academy 0. The nice thing is for Frontier is they have the depth to come off the bench that people can come and get a quick breather before going back out.
So Stella moving down the sideline. Tries to make a pass and it was intercepted. Smith, now Lila Roach has it. She's doing a good job to the ball and it's kicked out by the goalie. Now Harper makes a pass and I think it just goes out of bounds. Harper with it, trying to get into the box. Time is intercepted by Madison McKimmy. That's going to be a Lila Roach with it, doing a good job. Makes a pass inside the box. Now she has it again. And, oh.
Corner. So usually what you'll see is they'll be, depending on which side they're doing the corner on, one person is standing outside of the net, and that's your lead. They're going to, a lot of times that's the person that's going to run directly to where the first pass goes to. And then the follow is going to pick up a secondary pass.
Madison McKimmy with it. Pat, ooh, kicked out by the goalie again.
Oh, going wide. We get some fresh legs going in there for Frontier. And Smith Academy has no subs.
Yeah, that's going to be difficult late in the game.
We have a foot, so it's advantage Smith Academy right now. Have to physically show that you stop the ball before you can start again, and it has to start in the position in the approximate area where the infraction took place. So you'll see the refs, they'll back up the players. Nope, you gotta go to the left, you gotta go to the right. Okay, right there, you can drop the ball there.
Yeah.
Stay with it!
Harper Modesto going down field and stolen by Smith.
Whoop. You'll notice the ref will put their arm up if they're holding the ball. If the ball, so say Smith touches the ball with their foot, but Frontier is advancing towards the net, they're going to hold the whistle for a certain period of time. That if Frontier loses that momentum, then they'll have that delayed whistle call. Got a push. Another little push happening there.
Oh, nice save from going out of bounds, but it goes into Frontier. Ashley Golinski with now Harper gets it into the box.
Oh, we have a hack, so we're top of the circle.
Now Stella, have fun. Nope. Wow, the Roach with it. Oh.
Frontier ball out on Smith.
Yep.
And moving it through. Looks like Frontier has some of their younger players subbed in right now.
Yeah, because they got that 2-0 lead.
Yeah.
Kind of early on. Now, Smith trying to go down the sideline. Lila Roach makes a steal. She passes it off. To Rowan Riley now. Sticks with it. Stolen by Smith.
Ooh, okay. Frontier ball still.
No. Haley Dowski with it.
Right. Out on Frontier, so they're going to bring the ball up. Smith will start at the top of the circle. I think it was a foot.
Yeah.
He did that back pass. Now they're sending it to the circle in hopes of getting a touch on it.
Oh, almost.
And
there you
it's
go.
In.
It's Rowan Riley with the with the goal.
All right. So Frontier is 3. Smith Academy is 0. They did a great job being, as it was moving around, their sticks are on the ground. They were able to get the rebound off of the goalie.
Yeah, and Haley Hadowski, she made that long pass to get in there.
Exactly. If she had made that pass, if she made that drive from outside the circle and it went in without a Frontier player touching it, it would be no goal because you have to be within that circle in order. So the hope is to get that drive in and get a stick on it and get it in.
Roach with it. Pass it off to Ashley Galinsky. Tries to pass it up. It does.
Nice. Some nice give and goes going up here. Yeah.
Now back to Ashley. Ooh.
Ooh. Nice give and goes. Traveling, passing it. Ooh. Or a foot or a leg on us. Another foot.
And Ashley Galinsky makes a steal.
Oop.
Now,
right idea, but the sticks weren't, and alignment wasn't quite right there.
Now Smith Academy with a chance.
Oh, there's the half.
So after the first half, it's 3-0 Frontier with the lead. And just all around good half for Frontier. It's been very offensive for them. You know, they've kept it on the other side on Smith Academy side of the field.
Yes, definitely dominating offensively. Smith Academy goalie is working extremely hard. But you know, we're seeing a little bit of the youngness of the team from Smith.
Yeah.
And, you know, they it's always interesting to see the growth over the years as they get as they mature and they have more skills, as their skills building. In another year or two, Smith was going to, you know, can rally back and be a really strong team to be a be a strong contender.
Yep.
As with Frontier, you know, the last 4 or 5 years now, we've had the feeder program coming up from the rec department, and that has allowed us, even though we are a younger team, having that younger team, they're definitely stronger than what we would expect for their age group. So, even though we're a young team, there's that background.
All right. So, for the first half, it's 3-0. We'll be right back. You're watching Frontier Community Access Television. Hello and welcome back to Frontier Community Access Television. Tom Albert, Miss Chapley, and Alec Eckel. And so we just started the second half of action.
So Frontier had a very dominating first half offensively. Right now we've switched sides, so we're going to be looking at maybe the other end of the field.
So Frontier on the attack, Ashley Taylor, and it's nice clearance by Smith. Good job by keeping in bounds.
We have a great attendance happening here on the sidelines. Ooh, cut across. Nobody was able to get a stick on it, though. Went out of bounds.
Now, Smith going down the sideline. You got Catherine Kowalski. She's going to make a longer pass.
Nice strong pass. Oh, we got a foot.
Now Lila Roach with it. She passed it off. Madison McKimmy. Pass it up to Ashley Taylor.
Nice movement going up the field. You can hear them talking. You'll hear them say flat, which means to go horizontal. Through means to more in a forward direction. Ooh.
Ooh.
Yep. Missy has her starting lineup back out there for the start of the second half.
So for Smith, it's going to be Madison Renner. Oh, nope. It's going to be Charlotte Kavanaugh.
Frontier has been really doing really well at challenging the offensive moves by Smith and coming up strong with the ball.
Yeah, they haven't really given Smith a chance to get over to the other side. Now Ashley Taylor with it. She makes it a pass. Nice shot on goal.
Another shot on goal. Doing it again. Nice carry in. Corner. Foot.
And so Ashley Taylor's going to take the corner for Frontier. Goes outside. Pass it around.
Ooh.
Gets her in the, oh.
Nice. Almost nice move. Couldn't quite get a solid stick on that going to goal. But we got another corner. I think this is the hardest part is when you have the players that have to come back to the 50-yard line and it's back and forth. Like we saw that happen like three or four times in the first quarter.
Yeah, that's got to be tough for Smith.
And we had a foot on that. Didn't get a stick, got a foot. See if Smith can capitalize. Nice poke, poking it out from underneath her.
Now Frontier.
Oop. Ooh.
Nice steal by.
We got a hack, another start. Smith's trying to move it up the field by driving it. Which can work, but not all the time. Especially if you have players that know how to move to the ball real quickly.
Now Smith, they're going to have an advantage.
Oh. Got a big foot on that one.
Jillian Lavelle trying to go upfield.
Hack on Frontier. Ooh. All right, that was a foot on Smith. So.
Smith makes the steal. That's McKimmy. To Macy.
Ooh.
Yeah, it just goes
out of
bounds.
Didn't quite get there.
Yeah.
Go Frontier.
Open for. Nice stick, nice stop. Got it back. Under control. Pack.
Lila Roach with it. Trying to go down the sideline. Trying to get a pass off. Runs into. Still has it.
Ooh. Ooh. Two shots on goal. Corner. We got an interference, visual interference. A lot of. It was really interesting. The defenseman for Smith saved it one of the first times going to goal.
Yeah, now Frontier with another opportunity to score.
Sometimes you'll hear coaches say, every corner is a goal. Like, you have the advantage. Oh. Not quite sure. They called out a player. May have moved too fast.
Claire Kirkendall makes a big hack.
There we go. Maddie McKemmy with the goal and an assist. I'm not quite sure who passed it to her, though. That makes it 4 for Frontier and 0 for Smith. Every corner is a goal.
There you go. That time it was.
It definitely was. Oh, we're switching out goalies. So Ella Flanders is coming out. And our new goalie.
Is it Kyra Richards?
Kyra Richards coming in.
Now Frontier on the attack. Roach with it. Tries to. It's just going to go out of bounds.
Looks like it's out of bounds. Frontier's ball. Most likely she didn't start in the right place. Foot. Darn, those feet keep getting in the way.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice steal by Madison.
Trying to dish it out.
Didn't quite see the call. It was just like right there. A lot of back and forth. It can move pretty quickly.
Yeah. So Lila Roach, she's moving down the sideline and using the sideline to her advantage.
You can always use that sideline as like a helpful defensive person, because it's really hard as the defense to get to the ball because your body is between the ball and the line itself, especially on the strong side of the stick. Ooh, just passed in front. A couple more shots on goal. The Smith goalie is getting a workout today.
Yeah, they've been on. Frontier's been on the attack all game.
Didn't carry it 5 yards. So if you're below the 25-yard line and you don't carry it to 5 yards, then you lose possession of the ball. You either have to move it backwards or keep it on your stick for 5 yards moving forward.
And just goes out of bounds.
Oop. Interference body. Smith is trying to move it up by driving it. Nice pull and pull to the right and then go around your player. Sometimes you'll see them and they'll kind of they'll do like these little baby scoops over their sticks. It's a little harder to do it here on the field versus if you're doing it on turf.
Now,
heading into the corner there.
Ron Riley makes a pass. Just need one more.
Shot on goal.
Yeah. Ooh.
And we have a goal. I had too many people in front of me. I couldn't quite see who it was.
It may have been Madeline Ants. Yeah.
Number 11?
Yeah. Madeline Ants, yeah.
Okay. We have the ref, we have the players, we have the equipment. So now we're on running time, so they won't stop the clock for anything. If there's a timeout called, it's running time because it's a 5-0 game. But Smith Academy is not giving up.
Yeah. Frontier moving very fast.
Doing very well. You can hear some talking on the we can hear the talking here on the sidelines going out on the field. That's a key component to being successful at moving the ball.
Now, Smith on the attack. Trying to get by Harper.
Yep. It's the end of the third quarter?
Yep. So it's 5-0 after the third, and we will be right back. You're watching Frontier Community Access Television. Hello, and welcome back to Frontier Community Access Television. Tom Albermiss, Chapley, Alec Eckel. And back for the fourth quarter action. For Frontier, they leave 5-0.
We got 5-0, and it looks like Missy is got her younger players and giving them some game time experience, which is really important in bringing the program along. So right now we're on running time, so no matter what, the clock will continue to run. If someone is injured, if there's a timeout due to the 5-0 score.
Frontier's still on the attack. And
was a foot against Smith.
Abigail so, Grover.
Yeah, pass back. Oh, pass they're moving it across the field so they can come in and attack on their strong side. Oh, nice back pass. They're really taking advantage of if you can't go forward, passing it back and then coming in at passing it at a different angle to attack from a different angle. That's a really great skill and teamwork.
Now you got Stella Heflin. She's the ball. Trying to get back two Smith defenders, and she does. Now they're going to pass back. Claire Kirkendall. Pass it up to Abigail Grover.
Ooh.
Nice.
Right in front of the net. Ooh. Missed opportunity.
Yeah. on Frontier. They have a corner.
Every corner is a goal.
So Stella Heflin, she's gonna take the corner now. Clark, nice shot. Just goes wide left.
So Stella inserted straight to Claire. Claire clears it outside the circle and then a nice strong drive, but she did go wide. But when you can sink that really quickly, it can be such a power shot right on goal that it's done before you even knew it started.
Yeah. Frontier with a chance. Still a chance to score.
Ooh.
That's right. Oh.
You get excited. It's like, ooh, ooh, it's right there.
Yeah.
Ooh. Smith player taking advantage of using the sideline. Yep. Interference.
No.
With the strong drive to the circle. Frontier defense is just right there. They're jumping right on top of it.
Yeah, they've been doing a good job of that all game, so.
That was a foot. Oh, he's backing them up to where it started. All righty. So we have a timeout right now.
Yeah, and like you said, the clock's running.
Clock has continued to run, yep.
All right, so they're going to take a quick break. So we are watching Frontier Community Access Television. We'll be right back. Hello, and welcome back to Frontier Community Access Television. Tom Albert, Ms. Chapley, Alec Eckel. And it's 5-0. Frontier with the lead. So Claire Kirkendall, she's going to make a pass inside the box. And nice stop by the Eagles. The Falcons.
Oh, foot. I think we're getting a little tired. A lot of feet calls happening.
Yep. Now the Falcons on
but
the attack.
Smith is not giving up.
Now, Frontier, they're going to be on the attack. Nice stop by...
Yep, a little pushing going on, a little stick work. All right. Frontier's back on the attack again. Spread out nicely as they're coming in from their strong side.
Yeah, and they did a good job moving down that sideline again.
Oh. It's against Frontier. Most likely it was a foot. Ball was riding up on a lot of the sticks because they were just so bunched together.
Well, I get reports constantly.
Ooh. Another foot.
Not Frontier. How long are each quarters? Do you know?
What's that?
How long are each quarters?
15 minutes.
15 minutes.
I had to think about that for a minute. So it's a 60-minute game.
Yeah.
They used to do 2 30-minute halves. And then they broke them down. I think it was last year. Was it the year COVID? Where they did 4 quarters.
Yeah.
Because back when we were school was hybrid, they still had field hockey as a sport. Here we have 11-on-11 on a traditional on the standard field.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the fall of 2020, it was 7-on-7.
Yeah.
On a full field, and so you really needed to make sure that you could. Instead of doing a full 30 minutes, I think they broke it down to 2 15-minute halves just to give the players a little extra rest. Usually you don't see 7v7 except in tournament during a tie, which Frontier has routinely seen.
Yeah.
When they went to Western Mass. And you were saying at the beginning of the game that they have 2 ties.
Yeah.
So during regular season, it is only they'll leave it at as a tie. Oh, we got another corner. He signaled the corner and then he signaled away. So I think. I'm not quite sure what's happening. So basically it's a 1-on-1.
Oh.
Because of an infraction by Smith. How did we miss
that? So you got Claire Kirkendall, she's gonna take the 1-on-1.
Yep. So anybody on the team can take it?
Yeah.
Oh. It has to be one fluid movement.
Good save by the goalie.
Good save, yep. It's a lot of pressure being like the only one there. So there's a line. It's about seven yards from the goalie. And you can't dribble in. You just do it from a standing position. So usually you'll see those if you have a breakaway or it's an egregious infraction. Don't see too many of them. Let's put it that way. So the only, getting back to, you'll end a game in a tie during regular season, but in tournament season, they'll do 2 short periods of 7v7. If it's still tied, then they go to a shootout. And it's a sudden death. Situation 7v7, the first to score.
So if you miss on the first one, then and the other team scores, the other team wins.
Yeah. When you get to the shootout, which we did roughly 8 years ago, you get choose 5 people from each team, and at the end, whoever has the most at the shoot. After the shootout, we'll take it.
Yeah, so Frontier on the attack again. They call.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. Another corner.
Another corner.
Yeah.
Every corner is a goal. That's what we hope. Frontier midfielders are doing a really good job of getting that ball and keeping it inside the circle. But we had a foot, so it brings it back out to Smith. Smith's taking it up the field right now.
Smith trying to go down the sideline.
Nice steal right in front of us. Just to be able to bring that stick in, scoop it out, and move it away from the opposing team's stick. Doing the back pass. And that's game.
Yeah, so Frontier, they win 5-0. And they move to 5-1-2 on the season. So, any final thoughts, Ms. Chapley?
No, seeing the leagues over the year and the ups and the downs, it's great to see, you know, Frontier continuing even with a strong young team. They've had some major teams they've had to play. Long Meadow, who is consistently going to states, Minichog, Agawam. I'm trying to think of the higher division teams that they play, and you can't write out Smith Academy.
No.
By any means. They're going to continue to grow and get stronger, and so it's always good to see a good, strong team.
Yep. And Frontier played very well offensively and defensively as well. So, again, the final score, 5-0. Frontier wins. You're watching Frontier Community Access Television. We'll see you guys next time.